What's up, guys? The best class share back to another video. Dread 7,121 trophies. We're in top 42 in the world right now. And today we're playing some Valkyard's Log Bait on Ladder. If you're new to the channel, make sure you drop a like and subscribe if you haven't already. And hopefully searching for opponent doesn't take too long. Estimated time is currently 40 seconds. And there we go. And to the first match. Unfortunately, guys, I only got 18 wins in the global tournament. I just played it right before this video, started this video. I kept on losing to the lava Skelly King flying machine deck, which is really annoying. Anyways, let's see what our opponent's gonna play here. He has Dark Prince and Mega Minion. Also has Fisherman, really interesting deck. Okay, most likely gonna be RG, so it's okay leaking Elixir here. If you wait for the Fisherman to lock onto your tower and then you play your Valkyrie now, you actually reset and lock onto any troop. Okay, it's gonna be definitely gonna be a tricky matchup. But let's see what we can do, guys. Let's see, I wanna kill that hunter. Nice, log's gonna come down and do a good job. He does a really bad RG in the Dark Prince as well. He goes with the aggressive snowball, so we're going guards like this. And hopefully the Dark Prince doesn't kill our guards. Okay, we take some damage, but the Gonbarrel's gonna punish him. Yeah, he's going to low an elixir. He goes with a fireball, and I think that's so low an elixir, guys. Yep. That overcommitment, that was an overcommitment, the Dark Prince. It's definitely an overcommitment there. Let's go for a log here. Let's suck to an E-Spirit so we don't take the hit from the Mega Minion. Every bit of damage counts. You want to try to save your HP when you're playing against RG players, because they can also like fireball cycle you, and you got to watch out for that. It's very important to save your HP against RG. And let's see what our opponent's gonna do. Good Fisherman, so let's go guard the same lane. Hopefully he doesn't have Mother Witch or we're good to defend. And he's going for the Dark Prince again. So we're gonna play our Valkyrie a little higher this time, so it doesn't splash into our tower. And let's see. Let's go for a Princess like this. Try to force out Fireball or something. And yep, there's the Fireball from the opponent. Let's go for a log here to cycle, kill that hunter. Okay, we don't kill the hunter, that's fine. Let's go for our E-Spirit here to kite those guards to our Inferno Tower so we can defend. Nice, guys. And let's see. So we have the Fisherman. I'm going for Valkyrie here in case he wants to go with Dark Prince. And let's see. It's the Mega Minion, so let's go for guards here. Interesting RG ops lane from the opponent. Let's go for a log on that Dark Prince. Also applying pressure with the Gonbarrel here. Let's see. Very nice guards. Go for a high Inferno Tower, Valkyrie to block, and go for guards, help DPS down that. He goes with the second RG, that's cool. We can cycle back to another Inferno Tower here, which we are gonna do. He goes with the aggressive snowball. And he goes with the fireball as well, but that should not take out. Okay, actually takes our Inferno Tower in trouble. We're gonna sack some hits from the RG. Okay. And he still has to go with the Fisherman there. Hopefully your guards get some damage. Nice. We actually get some really nice damage there. We're taking that. And let's go Princess here to defend the Fisherman. He goes with the RG and the Dark Prince. Let's go for a high Inferno Tower, making sure we do not miss. Also, he might fireball, so let's go for guards on defense here. And we're pressuring with the Gonbarrel because we know he just has Snowball, and Snowball's not the best counter. Gonbarrel, yep. Yeah, he's going to take some damage there. And I think we're just one more log and rocket away, so let's see. It's E-Spirit here, saying thanks, don't know why. He's saying thanks. We just close the game with the Gonbarrel here because the tower's locked on, and we can rocket and log for the win. Even though he has RG, he won't get down in time, and really nice game there. Just saving our Inferno Towers for the RG and just defending whenever, and it's nice, nice plus 29. That puts us at top 200, really great. Maybe the goal of today's video is probably 7,200 trophies, which is 50 more trophies. That is two more games, and it's on to next match. Hope you guys enjoyed the video so far. If you did, drop a like and comment down below. I also read all of your guys' comments, so if you're wondering about something, you have a question, you should ask it down below. And a lot of people are asking, like, what current log bait deck should I use. If you're not level 14 yet, and you don't have max cards, just use your highest level cards, because log bait is, like, really level dependent. If you have underleveled cards, it might lose you some interactions, which should not go wrong. Anyways, we're in our match here against this dude. We've got Gombro in our hand. We're going for anti-NATO position here in the corner of the tower. And he's going for a log. Okay. He has a cycle deck, so let's see. We want your opponent to make the first move when your opponent's playing a cycle deck, so you can defend and make a counter push. Okay, there's the miner, so let's go for guards here. Okay, as far as spirit. And I don't want to go for princess, because he might have delivery, and that's bad. So let's see. He's going to Valkyrie. Okay, we're going for Valkyrie of our own. And it's going to be minor murder Arch Queen, so that's going to be bad. You get our rocket ready for his Arch Queen, because I know he's going to play it. Actually, we're going to go for our princess to snipe it. And he might go with a log on our princess. Let's go for a Gone Barrel. Actually, goes with the fireball instead. It's fine. Logs that. And we should log this queen. So, yeah, you try to use the ability there, but it doesn't work. And once again, guys, really nice. Fast cycle, minor, Arch Queen, Fire Spirit deck, which is going to be really hard for us to do anything. So far, East Spirit in the back here. Cycle guards in case he wants a minor. Goes with his own Fire Spirit. Okay, respect. And he goes with the Valkyrie, try to predict our Gombro. Let's go with Gombro here, because I think we outcycle this log, hopefully. We do. Okay, that's huge. And let's go for a Valkyrie here to force out the Arch Queen, which he might play soon. Yep, there it is. And let's see. Might rocket the Arch Queen, depending on what he will do. He's going to go with the mortar. So let's go for Inferno Tower, because I know he's going to use the ability. Yep. Nice. And hopefully the mortar doesn't... Okay, that's a problem. Okay, I think that will reset. No, it will not. I am mistaken. It's for a log here. And he might go with the Valkyrie behind a tower. Let's see. Yes, he does. Nice. He's going to do that. So I put our Goms in the front. He's going with another mortar, guys. So we're just going for Rocket here. And Electro Spirit. Hopefully we hit the log and catch something. Okay, we don't. Spirit guards high, so the Fire Spirit won't splash him to our tower. Okay. Very nice. Okay, let's go for Gombro applying pressure. Force out a log or something from the opponent. Yep. And he was actually late. And let's go for a high Inferno Tower, predict his mortar. Okay, if we don't get it, we actually get a Valkyrie. That's huge. So we're gonna block here, and he has to use the ability, which is good. And he's going for a desperate minor placement there. Totally disagree on. And okay. For log here. East Spirit, and then guards here. I know the guards were kind of bad, but they're gonna tank, and nice. He just used his log again. So we're Gombro applying pressure. And a princess as well. So we're East Spirit in case he wants to go with the Arch Queen or something. And we gotta sack that miner, which is okay. Okay, we're not too far behind, guys. And looking good. I don't want to rock that tower piece. We might just go with Queen, Fire Spirit, or something. He goes to the mortars. Go for Valkyrie and Inferno Tower here. And let's go for Gombro again on the tower. Let's go for a log. Let's go for Princess like this. He still has to use the ability, or the Queen's gonna die. Yep. And. He overcommitted. I think I'm gonna go for East Spirit and then guards. And let's go for a Valkyrie here. Okay, he goes for the log. Okay, let's go for a Gombro. And log, East Spirit, try to retarget the mortar, hopefully. Okay, it doesn't hit our tower. That's unfortunate. And let's go for guards to defend. Okay, he's going in all in, guys. So hopefully we can defend this. Nice. GG. Really nice game. This guy overcommitted with his spells and minor on a tower. Got greedy. And we managed to take W there because he had nothing for Gombro. He was low on elixir. And I think I played pretty well there. Not bad. And I'm actually going to open this chest real quick because I need some room. And it's 12 hours, so you always want to use your key on a chest that's like 12 hours or more. Nice. So I should open this one too. Quick. And looks like we're 17 trophies away from our goal. Time to next match today's video and hopefully enough of W. That was a really nice win against that Mortar minor player there, because that deck is like insanely hard counter, because they have Log, Valkyrie, Fireball, Fire Spirit to defend your Dombro, which is like half their deck. And it's really hard for you to defend because you have to spend more elixir to defend a Mortar for Inferno Tower, which is a negative one trade. Also distracting it with like East Spirit or guards in the middle also makes you spend more elixir. However, that guy got greedy and you ever take advantage of that. All right, in our next game here, got Log in our hand. Generally, if you have Log and you have nothing else, like no Princess or Gombro, you just want to wait a little bit to make sure you're not playing against a bait player. Super Guard's here to defend the Bandit. So we have the greedy match Archer, okay. He actually got a lot of damage. Okay, that's annoying. Lumberjack as well. So we're going for East Spirit like this and Princess here to defend the Lumberjack. Let's say we're going against a Randrider Bridge Spam deck, which is not fun. We can't really use our Gombrels at all because they always see it and always log, always Barbarrel the Gombrel. For instance, I'm going to go for Gombrel here and he's just going to Barbarrel it. Or he has Log. Cycle guards and pray that he doesn't magic archer or anything, do anything crazy. It's for East Spirit in case he wants to do that. He doesn't. Let's see, he does do it in fact. Okay, that's kind of cringe. And he gets a lot of damage because of doing that, because that's kind of no skill. And let's see here, guys. Okay, that's a really nice queen picked up on our princess. And he goes for the Armorjack as well. Okay, guys. Let's throw the Log here. And guards in the center help defend. Okay, wow, East Spirit comes down late and Queen gets a lot of shots on her tower. Okay, it's not looking good. This guy has a matchup for sure because it's a fast cycle and hard for us to defend, and he can just defend easily because he has a lot of counters. He has like Fireball, Log, Super Gombro here. Yeah, I think we gotta sack or do something crazy. Okay, he goes with the Log there. So we gotta do something crazy and just spam here, guys, and pray he doesn't have Mega Knight. Okay, he doesn't have Mega Knight, that's good. He had to Fireball that. And Bandit's actually gonna go to that side and actually, okay, that's good for us. Log everything here. And I think we gotta take the charge hit from the Randrider. From the Bandit. Hopefully if we don't get killed by that Lumberjack, we should be fine. Okay, that was the best interactions we could have done. Let's go for a Valkyrie there to predict his Match Archer, but if we don't, that's okay. Really nice match archer placement from the opponent there, playing in the back. And a really nice Log as well. So overall, this guy's playing pretty well. And we're actually slowly crawling back in damage, which is kind of funny. Let's go for a Log, killing that match archer. It's going for a really nice Fireball. So let's go for guards like this, defend the Lumberjack. And let's go for a high Inferno Tower, try to snipe that. Played it too high, which is unfortunate. It's going to use the ability there. And let's see. Okay, really nice Bandit from the opponent. So our guard's gonna be late here. Yeah, it's gonna be GG. The Bandit's gonna take our tower soon. And yeah, Fireball comes down, and I think he just needs Log or two Logs to win. And let's go for Princess, trying to make something happen, but his tower's way too healthy, and he can just defend easily. Arch Queen, okay. Yeah, this guy's deck is really strong because it has Arch Queen and Match Archer. If they have both, it's like really hard to defend in general. So Valkyrie, he also has Randrider and great pressuring cards. Let's go for Gombro here. And he's going to take the tower there, Match Archer. So good game, well played. This is a really tough matchup, and it would have been better if he had the Tesla version of Log Bait, because that's really good against Bridge Spam. And I might actually switch to Tesla, guys. And hopefully you don't face Lava Hound, because today we faced Mortar, Miner, bridge spam, and forgot what our first match was, but I don't think it was Golem or anything crazy. So it looks like Tesla is good. Hopefully I don't jinx myself. Because you guys have recognized that playing against decks that are not like really friendly against Inferno Tower, like Motorcycle or Bridge Spam, you can just switch to Tesla and it helps defend much better. All right. Hopefully we're not playing against Giant Graveyard because, okay, that is bad. Opponent has a Lava Hound. Let's go for Gombrel. Valkyrie pressure here. He's gonna go over the Flying Machine. Okay. To be honest, guys, I don't know where to play my Tesla because I'll just let. Okay, like this maybe to defend the Flying Machine. I don't know. But let's see. Yep, he's going for a clone. And yeah, that's gonna be Tower Down. No doubt about it, guys. That's Tower Down. And we're going against one of the hardest counters if you have Tesla. So bad call on my part, guys. I don't think it's a good idea to switch to Tesla because my luck is absolute garbage. And we just lost a tower because of that. And it's gonna be really hard to defend at all. Let's go for Gombrel. Christian Log tried to Skeleton Army. Can we get some of it? So we get one hit. And the best we can do is cycle Teslas because that's what I've been hearing people say to do. So I'm going to do that. Play Tesla here. And it puts me over Lava Hound, so I'm going to go pressure right away. The E Spirit Ready hits wants to play Bats. He does not, so it's fine. We do get the BB Dragon out of hand, but it's going to go towards our Tesla and kill it faster, so which is not good. Try to make it survive the E Spirit here. Okay, that was a bad E Spirit. My bad, guys. And let's see here. Okay, he's going Bats and Fireball. And okay, that was a really nice clone because it forced out a rocket here. And that is really unideal for us. Yeah, we can't defend that. Because he has Fireball and Clone, that's really annoying. And pretty much gonna be a GG, because we can't come back from this, no way. Gombrel Prediction Log on a Skeleton Army again. We don't hit it, that's fine. And the best thing we can do is go for a 3 crown, but I doubt that's gonna happen. It's a really nice Flying Machine for support. Yeah, it doesn't look like we're gonna get 3 crown in time, guys. So the best we can do is pray. Okay, yeah, he's waiting for the 3 crown of his own. Yeah, it's really hard for us to defend at all. Yeah, we can rock the Flying Machine, but he's already back to another one, so there's no point. Yeah, it'd be GG. This is why I don't use Tesla. I think it's not good against Lava Hound because you can't defend it. He just dies instantly to like Flying Machine or Fireball or Miner, any support card. So that's why I'm going to switch back to Inferno Tower. Hopefully, ending off today's video with a W. Once again, searching for opponent should not take that long. Okay, we're in the match here. Yeah, Gombrel in her hand. Not bad. Opponent's going over the Wall Breaker, so we're going to go for a Log this side. And guards for the defend. Let's see, opponent's got Skeletons as well. And that is a Goblin Drill. Let's go for E-Spirit here and Valkyrie to defend everything. He's got Magic Archer. Okay, and we're gonna actually log that. Okay, that's really annoying. So we're gonna go for Princess, help defend everything. And I'm just going for, okay. Going for Gombrel now, guys. And I might go for Skeletons for a Princess. Okay, nice. That was actually really excellent. I'm gonna ignore that Wall Breaker because I can take some damage because I took some damage here. And look at that, guys. He just overcommitted that Magic Archer to bridge, and that's what he gets. And really bad Tesla, because that's a waste of 4 Elixir. And I think I can just rock the tower here, because I have no other better play. You just need to play responsive in this match. Let's try to get lucky in case he wants to play something in the back, but I doubt it. Also use his Wall Breaker, so he can't like make a massive offense on us. Here, watch out for his NATO Magic Archer. That's like the dangerous combo. And by doing that, we can just block by Inferno Tower playing Valkai. Okay. Let's go for Inferno Tower like this. And let's get our Princess Raikis wants a Magic Archer or something. He does, so let's go for Princess like here. over here to snipe it. Perfect. I should go for a log to kill it. Nice. Try to use a NATO, which failed on this part. And let's go for a Gombrel applying pressure. Goes over the log. So in this case, we're just going to rocket a tower. Because we just played defensive, we can just defend his Gombrel easily. So here's some rocket, guys. Here's the Gombrel. Let's play a Valkyrie in the front here to defend it. Yeah, that's a really bad placement. And we played our log too early, but that's fine. And we just get our Princess high. Yeah, he's going to play Magic Archer. It's really nice. We can just snipe it easily with ease. And let's go for a high Inferno Tower to block it even more. So our Princess survives. It's going to be really annoying for him. Okay, there he goes. Just going for a log here. He uses this. So let's go for a Gombrel in front. Fail NATO from the opponent. You know, imagine if he failed that. And let's go for Rocket just in case he wants to Magic Archer that. Yeah, Rocket here. Okay, that didn't matter because the Valkyrie was locked onto the Magic Archer, but safe than sorry. Let's go for Guards here to defend. He might go with Wallbreakers, so let's go for Inferno Tower high. And he goes with a really cheap NATO, so let's go for Log. Let's go for a Princess applying pressure. Force out a Magic Archer. Okay, guys, and let's go for Gombrel like this. Goes with the Valkyrie. So let's go Valkyrie over our own. Defend that easy. And I think we're two rockets and two logs, so let's go for Rocket here. Guards to defend. And he's probably gonna he's not gonna needle those guards away, so let's go for a log and Inferno Tower here. Okay, it's gonna get tricky, so we gotta watch out. Okay, really bad NATO, and yeah, he's laughing about it. He knows it's not the best, and that's really bad Magic Archer. And we're gonna take the game there. Really nice rocket. Thought we needed the log as well, but we didn't. GG. Cringe deck, of course. This NATO Magic Archer as a win condition is not